نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد. Honorable and respected mothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Our respected Maulana Ashraf Sahab have recited some verses from Surah Ash-Shu'ara. Almighty Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala refers to five du'as of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. رَبِّ هَبْ لِي حُكْمًا وَأَلْحِقْنِي بِالصَّالِحِينَ. O Allah, grant me hikmat. Commentators of the Quran explain hukman as knowledge of deen. وَأَلْحِقْنِي بِالصَّالِحِينَ. O Allah, join me, attach me with the pious people. وَاجْعَلِّي لِسَانَ صِدْقٍ فِي الْآخِرِينَ. And O Allah, make me a true legacy for the people to come afterwards. And when I leave this world, وَاجْعَلْنِي مِنْ وَرَثَةِ جَنَّةِ النَّعِيمِ. And O Allah, make me among the heirs, the inmates of Jannatul Na'im. وَاغْفِرْ لِأَبِي إِنَّهُ كَانَ مِنَ الضَّالِّينَ. O Allah, forgive my father, for he is deviated. This was a dua before the prohibition on Ibrahim alayhi salatu wa salam. وَلَا تُخْزِنِي يَوْمَ يُبْعَثُونَ. O my Allah, do not disgrace me. Do not humiliate me on that day when people will be resurrected. يَوْمَ لَا يَنْفَعُ مَالُ وَلَا بَنُونَ. On that day when the wealth of people and the children, progeny of people will not avail him. إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهِ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. The only thing that will avail a person on the day of Qiyamah will be that person that will come in the court of Allah with a sound heart. These are the five du'as of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. Understand the context of the du'a of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam. These du'as were made in a very challenging time. When Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was faced with an adverse condition of inviting the people towards Tawheed, the oneness of Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he asked his family people, why do you worship these idols? They cannot listen, they cannot hear, they cannot help you, they cannot assist you. Why do you worship them? And then he defines who Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is. Who is, what is his belief? الَّذِي خَلَقَنِي فَهُوَ يَهْدِينَ وَالَّذِي يُطْعِمُنِي وَيَسْقِينَ وَإِذَا مَرِدْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينَ. That my Allah is such, when I'm hungry, he gives me food to eat. When I'm thirsty, Allah gives me water to drink. When I'm ill, due to climatical change, whatever the situation is, Allah is the one that grants me shifa. وَالَّذِي أَتْمَعْ أَن يَغْفِرَ لِي خَطِيئَةِ يَوْمَ الدِّينَ. And Allah is such that I'm hopeful that the day I die, when I meet my Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala will forgive me on the day of Qiyamah. The five du'as of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam was within an adverse context in which he was inviting his family people towards the oneness and tawheed of Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. The very last part of the dua, illa man atallaha biqalbin saleem. The only thing that will help a person on the day of Qiyamah is a sound heart. We just go back to five verses of this particular verse. What is that that constitutes a sound heart? Three things. First, Rabbi Habli Hukman. O Allah, grant me ilme deen. When a person has knowledge for deen, that contributes toward the person having a sound heart. One of the greatest ni'mat and bounties of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala upon an individual, that Allah grants him, guides him towards seeking the knowledge of deen. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reported to have mentioned, إِذَا مَاتَ إِبْنُ آدَمْ إِنْ قَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ فَلَاسِ. When a human being passes away, every act of his terminates with the exception of three. First, ilmun yuntafa'u bihi. Knowledge through which people benefit. I understand you come here every week. Tafsir programs are taking place. Knowledge is being disseminated. You are empowering yourself. You are migrating from ignorance to knowledge. This is a very great act of ibadat. And it is a means for you, for your sawab-e jariya. The second part in the hadith is sawab-e jariya. What will benefit a person after a person passes away? You contributed towards the madrasa. You contributed towards the development of an institute. You have all done this all for the pleasure of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Whatever you have contributed will never be in vain. It will never be wasted. Everything is recorded in the court of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. It was very pleasing to know that the mothers, the sisters that are here, you have contributed towards this institute. It's a small budding flower, but tomorrow it will become a huge orchard, the flowers of which, the reward of which will be attributed to your account in the Akhirah. And the third is that when a person passes away, he leaves a pious child, and the pious child will make dua for the parent after the person has passed away. The first condition for Qalb-e Salim, knowledge, contribution toward knowledge. One is to seek knowledge, and one also to contribute towards an institution of knowledge. Today, the greatest demand of the time is ilm-e-deen and guiding the people towards the correct path. The second, knowledge alone is not sufficient. Al-hiqni bis-saliheen. Oh Allah, guide me, attach me to the pious people. One is knowledge and one is suhbat. Staying in the company of the sulaha, staying in the company of the pious people, knowledge alone is just academics. Translate that academic into action, that is through the company of the sulaha to the pious people. And the third is, after you practice on the knowledge, sound knowledge, you work among the people, you leave a true legacy. And it's not only a legacy that you leave for the people, your own akhirat will also be done. وَاجْعَلْنِي مِنْ وَرَثَةِ جَنَّةِ النَّعِيمِ. That, oh Allah, make me among the heirs of Jannatul Na'im. And then Ibrahim alayhi salatu wasalam speaks about that إِلَّا مَنْ أَتَى اللَّهَ بِقَلْبٍ سَلِيمٍ. Sound heart, three things for a sound heart. And another important aspect for a sound heart is to keep the heart pure, keep the heart clean. Remove dirt. Remove ill feelings. Remove animosity from the heart. If a person wants to get close to Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, then just keep your heart pure, keep your heart clean. Remove ill feelings. Remove animosity from the heart. If there's a container in which the container is clean, you put uncrystallized water in that container, then that water will still come out clean. And you have another container that is filthy and dirty. If that dust, you can put the most crystallized water in that container. What will come out of it will be dirt. Keep our heart pure and clean. Little ibadat will make, will reach Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala very quickly. And if you exert yourself in ibadat, but there's ill feeling, there's animosity in the heart, then you will become an obstruction for your own taraqqi and the progress in your ruhaniyat and your spirituality. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reported to have mentioned to Hadha Anas radiallahu ta'ala anhu, ya bunay, that oh my child, in qadarta an tusbiha wa tumsi wa laysa fi qalbika ghashun ya had faf'al. If it is possible for you to spend the morning and the evening in such a way that there's no ill feeling in your heart for the next person, let it be so. Oh my son, this is my sunnah, keeping the heart pure and clean, no ill feeling for the next person. Everyone that you see, you have a clean heart. No heaviness in your heart. You don't look at a person with a negative eye. Keep a heart pure and clean. That is my sunnah. And oh my son, that person who loves my sunnah, indeed that person loves me. Our claim for the love of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam should not just be a verbal claim. It should not just be an emotional claim. It may be something that is translated from emotion into action. And then Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam mentioned, وَمَنْ أَحَبَّنِي كَانَ مَعِي فِي الْجَنَّةِ. That person who really loves me, follows my sunnah, indeed he will be with me in Jannah. How do we get Jannatul Na'im? Then Nabi Ibrahim alayhi salam, 5 du'as, teaches it to us. Attach yourself with ilm-e-deen. Make your islah. Stay in the company of the sulaha. Stay in the company of the pious people. Work among the people. Leave a true legacy. The mothers, the sisters that have contributed towards this institute. Indeed, it is waj'alli lisana sidqin fil akhir. That you have left a legacy, life is going to carry on. Whatever you have contributed, that same amount of money that you contributed, it would have went away somewhere else. And that's the end of it. You contributed here, this is going to grow to such an extent that you're going to see the real fruits of it in the qabr and in the akhirat. We make dua, Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, accept this institute, the program that takes place here on a weekly basis. It is indeed very pleasing to note that the mothers and sisters attend this program with that zeal, with that enthusiasm. And indeed, when you are coming here, you are actually coming in the path of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. In one hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reported to have mentioned, Man kharaja fi talabi al-ilm fahuwa fi sabilillah. That person that comes out in a search of knowledge, he is in fi sabilillah. And in fact, in one hadith, he mentioned that if a person comes out in search seeking knowledge, and the person happened to pass away, such a person is actually a shaheed, a martyr, because this is, you are exerting yourself in seeking ilm-e-deen, seeking the knowledge of deen and sharia. So make dua, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, accept the institute, accept the principal, accept all the asatidah, the administration. There may be many silent soldiers behind what is budding over here, and more so the mothers and sisters. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala preserve it for the qabr and akhirat. May Allah accept it, and may Allah get happy and pleased. The greatest thing that we should work for and seek, what is one min Allah akbar. The pleasure of Allah is the greatest thing. And Nabi Kareem taught us this dua, Allahumma inna nas'aluka ridaka wal jannah. Oh Allah, we ask of you your ridha. Allah, we ask of you jannah. Whatever contribution you make here in the world, you'll make somebody happy. They probably may not get happy. Allah is shakur, Allah values, Allah appreciates. So whatever you want to contribute in this madrasa, through your physical self coming here. Second, your moral loyalty to the madrasa. Third, financial support. And fourth, which is the most important, dua for the madrasa. That all that, it will come into your account. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala accept it. Wa akhiru da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik wa tabarak asmuka wa ta'ala jadduka wa la ilaha ghayruk. الحمد لله حمدا خالدا مع خلودك ولك الحمد حمدا دائما مع دوامك اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل وأصحاب سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها ومولاها اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان اللهم اجعلنا من الراشدين اللهم اجعلنا من الهادين اللهم اجعلنا من المهتدين اللهم بارك لنا في الموت وفيما بعد الموت اللهم حاسبنا حسابا يسيرا Oh Allah, out of infinite grace and mercy, forgive us each and every sin of ours. Oh my Kareem Allah, oh my Rahim Allah, we are very, very sinful. We are sinful from the head to the toe. With every part and every limb of our body, we have committed sins. Oh my Kareem Allah, forgive us the sin that we have committed with our eyes. Allah, forgive us the sin that we have committed with our ears. Forgive us the sin that we have committed with our tongues. Allah, forgive us the sin that we have committed with our hearts and our minds. Oh Allah, forgive each and every sin of ours. Forgive the sins of our mothers, our fathers, our brothers, our sisters. Allah, forgive the sin of the entire ummah of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Allah, accept this madrasa, accept this institute. Oh Allah, let it grow from strength to strength. Oh Allah, you know the needs of this madrasa. Oh Allah, create asbab and mean to fulfill this madrasa, to fulfill the requirements of the madrasa. Oh Allah, inspire the principal, inspire the asatida, inspire the student, all of those people that are contributing to the madrasa. Oh Allah, you accept it for your ridwan and your pleasure and make it a great treasure for them in the qabr and the akhirat. Oh Allah, accept our dua in the tufail of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jazallahu anna Muhammad sallallahu وآله وسلم وأهله. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحاب سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين.